What's up? My name is Matt, and today I wanted to talk about something that I think is an awesome upgrade for your PC gaming setup, and that is these adjustable monitor stands. So I'm going to tell you what I like about these, what they can do, and then what to look out for when buying one, just to make sure you get the right one for your setup. And I also wanted to mention that adjustable stands like this can range in price. This particular one cost me about $40, and they can be found from anywhere between $25 and over $100. So my favorite thing about these stands is that to adjust your monitor, all you have to do is grab it, put it where you want, and let go, and it'll just stay there. Unlike other stands where your screen's not where you want it, so you get all behind it, and you adjust some screws and tighten it, and you take a step back and look at it, and oh, it's still not where I want it, and you have to go back and repeat the process again, and do it a couple times to get everything all right, where here you just move it, okay, that's good, you let go. So these are great for customizing your setup, getting things just how you want it. You know, maybe you want to try a portrait layout one day. Bam, would that take half a second? Then you decide, I want to go back. There we go, I'm right back. And then another great thing about these is that, let's say you need to plug in a new cable. Well, then you can just spin it sideways, plug in whatever you need to do, and then put it right back, not having to get all underneath there to plug something new in. And these also save a ton of space on your desk compared to the stands that come with your monitors. And these are great for ergonomics because you can get the screen right where it needs to be so you're comfortable where you're sitting at. Whereas if you had a monitor that didn't have a height adjustable stand like this one, you're gonna be looking down at the monitor, you're gonna be cramping up your neck. And it's nice being able to bring your monitor closer to your eyes without the stand interfering with your keyboard and mouse, and you can even have your monitor over your keyboard if you want to. And another thing I like about these is that you don't have to drill into your wall or into your desk to set them up. So if later down the road you decide, you know, you wanna move your desk to the other side of the room, you're not gonna have to be patching up holes in your wall. So this stand was pretty easy to set up. Out of the box, I just had to put these two arms together and put the clamp on the bottom. And then you just slide it onto the back of your desk and tighten the clamp down. And here's where I had an issue with this particular stand. Usually you'll take this part off and attach this to the back of your monitor. And then with your monitor, you slide it back on and then you're good to go. But I had clearance issues with this part trying to slide it on. So I ended up having to get the whole stand with it flapping around and then screw it onto the back of my monitor and then try to slide it onto the back of my desk and clamp it on there. So it was kind of a pain, nothing you can't handle, but now that it's on there, I don't ever have to deal with it again. So when you get your monitor on there, you have to go in and set this little spring. And what this does is it makes it so when you let go of your monitor, it doesn't push it up or it doesn't sag. You get it right in the sweet spot where when you let go, the monitor just stays where it is. So again, you can adjust this stand in a lot of different ways. Up and down, you have a foot of motion. Side to side, you have 3 feet of motion. And front to back, you have about a foot and a half of motion. So if you're looking into getting one of these, here's what to look out for. You know, it's always good to check reviews on products when you're buying online, you know, make sure people are happy with it. And what I saw was a lot of people that were disappointed in their stands, especially the cheaper ones, were people with heavier monitors. So I would highly recommend looking up the weight of your monitor and then make sure your stand is rated to hold that much. And really, if you have a 16:9 monitor that's, you know, 24 inches or maybe 27, you're probably good with any stand. But I saw a lot of people with ultra wides, you know, having issues with these sagging no matter how much they tighten the spring. So just something to look out for. So I will have an affiliate link for this particular stand down in the description. And you know, the only reason I picked this one was because it was in all black. I thought it looked nice, but honestly, it's behind my monitors. I never see it, so it doesn't really matter. And I've been really happy with these, and ever since I got them, I just can't go back to regular stands. So I hope you all found this video helpful. If you did, please don't forget to leave a thumbs up, and I'll catch you in the next one.